So we're here and we're barred from the Clayton Manor. This is where Henry Clay Frick used to live with all of his family. He was manufacturing coke for steel manufacturing. And so Carnegie took him in, took his company in. He was put as like a VP kind of for Carnegie. And he ran all of the steel mills and stuff in Pittsburgh. So Frick and Carnegie and all these guys, they all used to live right here. Mellon, Hines, and they also had another place over at Johnstown. They had this club up where they dammed up the lake. For years, the locals were complaining that the dam was falling apart and needed repairs. And so in 89, there was torrential rains and they tried to build spillways, but the dam came down and this entire lake comes falling down on Johnstown. 2,000 confirmed casualties, probably more. So it was at least 10% of the town died. Johnstown, which basically becomes the most haunted place in all of Pittsburgh. You have people who are killed by the tsunami, and then you have people who are killed by all of the boilers as they are knocked over and pour fire all over this town. And all the houses that just got destroyed are now on fire.
That's so
everyone's dying.
What did Frick do about it?
Frick did nothing. Carnegie, he complains. He writes a letter to his family and he complains. He's like, yeah, my lake just destroyed a town, but also Paris was really hot. Nothing happens. And so there's so much ire building in Johnstown for that. So then when you come in 3 years later and you have the Homestead Steel Strike, you're waiting for this war to happen. Literally with barrels of oil set on fire and thrown down the river so that they can blow up the striking steel workers. Like,
how was any of this legal?
They just owned America. When Carnegie takes Frick's company, he makes the first ever billion-dollar company. Like, they just, there's nothing they can't do in Pittsburgh if they wanted to.
Yeah.
So Frick is crushing the Homestead steel mill strike. He hires 300 armed men to go shoot at them, and I think they shoot back.
Whoa.
And so 10 people die, dozens injured, and just a pretty contentious time. And so some guy just walks into his office one day and just points a gun at him, shoots him in the neck, and he's on the floor, and the guy's like, that didn't seem to do it.
So
he goes up and he shoots him again, and he hits the other side of his neck. Frick is like, he's dazed, but he gets up, and another executive shows up, and they grab the guy, and they wrestle him to the ground, and the guy takes out a knife, and he stabs Frick 4 times in the leg. They get him off, they restrain him, so Frick's there, they've gotten this guy to the police. The doctors come in, and he refuses all anesthetics, because he needs to direct the doctors of how to do the surgery on him. And they finally get it after hours, and he gets up and he goes right back and sits at his desk and starts signing papers and filling out forms.
A true businessman.
They convince him to go back over here to Clayton. Before he gets out of his office, he sends a telegram to his mother that reads, "Was shot twice, but not dangerous." And then he goes outside and he tells the crowd, you know, he says, "I might die, but even if I die, we're still going to keep crushing those unions." And then he goes back to Clayton. His wife gives birth to another child who dies several days later. And they're both bedridden at the time, both too sick to come down. And the funeral for the boy is held downstairs while they're both upstairs in their separate bedrooms.
Who's showing up at this funeral?
I don't know, but they kept showing up. Because years later, people keep on reporting that the whole wake for the funeral keeps on showing up at the mansion.
As ghosts.
So the guy who shot Frick says that he missed him because there was a blinding light in his eye coming in from the window. Well, Frick's office faced north, and at 2 p.m. in July, there could have been no light coming in through the window.
Okay.
And so Frick doesn't talk about this for decades. And then finally, he talks to some random reporter, and he tells the reporter, yeah, so basically, when the guy came up to shoot me, my daughter appeared right next to me, and I almost went to go hug her because she was so real. And the blinding light from that apparition caused the guy to miss his shot twice. So Frick does it. Frick spends several more years and crushes the unions.
Because of the ghost of his dead sister?
Yeah, for his daughter, he crushes the unions. Happily ever after for the Frick family, except for the several dead children and ghosts and the rest of Pittsburgh that becomes a just haven for ghost story.
Do you feel any ghosty energy?